Welcome, my dear students. In this section, I'll start with the water-soluble vitamins. So, which are the water-soluble vitamins? All the vitamins, including all the B-complex vitamins and vitamin C, come under the category of water-soluble vitamins. So, let us start with the first vitamin, vitamin C. Again, I'll be talking under these headings more than the other things. So, toxicity on excess intake, whether it happens till that. So, what is the vitamin C chemistry? What do you think it is? Can it be synthesized within the body? No, it cannot be synthesized. But it is looks many closely related to the hexoses. Actually, in primates and other below organisms, they are synthesized from glucose. Vitamin C can be synthesized from the glucose in other organisms, but in human it is not possible. It is water soluble and heat labile. It is known as ascorbic acid, and there are two forms of vitamin C: L-ascorbic acid, which is the reduced form, and dehydro-L-ascorbic acid, which is the oxidized form. Dehydro means it has lost its two hydrogen atoms, so ascorbic acid and dehydro-L-ascorbic acid. Again, why L? Again, it is related to hexoses, same as stereoisomerism, but from now onwards I'll be using the term ascorbic acid and dehydroascorbic acid, reduced in the oxidized form. What are the sources? Now, all the citrus foods like lemon, orange, sweet lime are good sources of vitamin C, gooseberry, guava, green vegetables, tomatoes, pullavas, etc., potatoes, etc. Now, the RDA is around 60 milligrams per day in adults and 70 to 95 milligrams per day during pregnancy and lactation. And it goes up to 100 milligrams per day for smokers. For the rest, it doesn't matter, but if somebody is smoking, the vitamin C RDA goes up to 100 milligrams per day. So, what are the biochemical functions of vitamin C? Now, first and foremost, it is involved in collagen formation. Again, I tell you where in collagen formation, it is involved in the hydroxylation of collagen molecule. So, whenever that alpha chain is the pro alpha chain, pre pro to pro alpha chain. So, this alpha chain is undergoing a post translational modification, and this is done by lysyl hydroxylase. So, both proline and lysine, what we call lysine and proline, hydroxylase. Okay, hydroxylase. Remember, there is one more enzyme involved in collagen synthesis known as lysyl oxidase. Lysyl oxidase does not require vitamin C. It is lysyl hydroxylase which requires. Lysyl oxidase is involved in cross-linking of collagen molecules. This is involved in hydroxylation of the alpha chain. So all the proline and the lysine residues in collagen are undergoing hydroxylation, and this is the most important function of vitamin C. Why? Collagen, there are so many different types of collagen, and they are distributed in basement membrane, they are distributed all over the body. Collagen forms a structural component of the body, and so hence any deficiency in collagen, it can result in decreased hydroxylation, and it can affect all the different types of collagen in the endothelial membrane, in the bones, wherever collagen is involved, all these places vitamin C can affect. So the main function of vitamin C is in collagen formation. Now in all this, it is converted between that L-ascorbic acid to the dehydroascorbic acid. It is also involved in iron metabolism. How? It is required to keep that ferrous to ferric to ferrous. In this condition, wherever ferric is required, it is going to act, and whereas ferrous is required, there also vitamin C is required. Vitamin C actually increases the absorption of iron by converting ferric to ferrous, and ferrous is the form which can be absorbed into the intestine and into the blood. So vitamin C converts all the ferric ions into ferrous ions and helps in the absorption of iron. It has a role even further along in the metabolism of iron. Hemoglobin metabolism, again, it is because of its antioxidant activity that it is involved. It is involved in tryptophan metabolism, tyrosine metabolism. Most of the cases, it is formation of DOPA, serotonin, etc. So, in all these things, what is happening? Vitamin C, when it is required in these, When vitamin C is deficient, tryptophan metabolism is affected. When vitamin C is deficient, tyrosine metabolism is defected, and catecholamines are defective, because from tyrosine we are going to get the different neurotransmitter. So vitamin C is required for neurotransmitter formation. So decreased vitamin C, decreased neurotransmitters also. Folic acid metabolism, also vitamin C is involved, and cholesterol metabolism, everywhere vitamin C is involved. So it is also involved in the synthesis of hormones like corticosteroids, adrenaline and noradrenaline. As I was telling, tyrosine to DOPA to dopamine to adrenaline and noradrenaline, catecholamines. Vitamin C also has some functions in phagocytosis and synthesis of immunoglobulin. Thereby, it helps in the immunity of the body. So, these are the different metabolic functions of vitamin C. Naturally, since minute it is ascorbic acid and you have got oxidized in a reduced form, most of the things which are involved in oxidation reduction are involved with cellular respiration, that is the electron transport chain. One way or the other, they will be involved with the electron transport chain and bring about synthesis of ATP. So when they are deficient, synthesis of ATP can decrease. And free radical damage can occur, because free radicals are going to be taken care of because of the antioxidant activity of these vitamins, especially vitamin C, vitamin E, etc. So it is a water soluble antioxidant. Vitamin E is fat soluble, so it will be present in the membranes, whereas vitamin C will be present in the cytosol, and there it acts as an antioxidant. So, what will be the deficiency symptoms of vitamin C? As I said, it is involved in hydroxylation reactions. So, hydroxylation of proline and lysine residues in collagen. So, if collagen is not there, it will result in a disease called as scurvy, where the collagen proper formation is not there. So, this deficiency is usually seen in infants or in elderly people, where the intake is less. So in mild deficiency, what will happen? There will be easy bruising. Again, why? Because the blood vessels contain the basement membrane, which is made up of collagen. So blood vessel collagen is the one which is going to get affected. So there will be easy bruising. Small minor thing, it will result in bruising. It can cause contusion. Small minor, they won't even be remembering the injury, but there will be a big contusion formed. It will also result in petechiae. These are small pinpoint hemorrhages, especially visible in the skin. Fair skin, it is visible more. Mild deficiency can also lead to frequent infections because their immunity is affected. Now in scurvy, proper scurvy, there is deficient collagen formation. So collagen is required for gums. So gums get soft and swollen and bleeding. They will start bleeding, again fragile. The teeth will become loose. Remember, vitamin C is also required for bone, because the collagen is involved in bone. That is what forms the osteomatrix. That is also not being formed properly. It can lead to loose teeth. Muscle weaknesses can be seen. Anemia can be seen. And swollen joints because of bleeding could be because of the collagen itself. Delayed wound healing is one more characteristic feature of scurvy. Poor healing of fractures, osteoporosis. Why? Again, as I said, collagen is present in bone also. So again, it can lead to poor healing of fractures and also osteoporosis. So scurvy, all these features are seen. Immune incompetence and hormonal imbalances. Neurotransmitters may be affected. Hormones, different hormone synthesis like adrenaline, noradrenaline or any other hormones also require. Corticosteroid synthesis requires vitamin C. So it can lead to ultimately hormonal imbalance. So that finishes vitamin C, one of the water soluble vitamins. A brief overview. Now let us go to the next vitamin, that is thiamine. Now I want you to look at one thing, the spelling of thiamine and thymine. Thiamine, this is thiamine, because T-H-I-A-M-I-N-E. Whereas there is one more, please don't confuse both of them. Thiamine is a vitamin and thymine is a base is a base, pyrimidine base, that is involved in DNA and RNA. So thymine, not in RNA, T is replaced by U. So thymine and thiamine, these are the two differences that you will have to be always aware of. This is the vitamin and this is the base, pyrimidine base. So it is vitamin B1. Again, numbers are important. So vitamin B1. What is the chemistry, sources and RDA? It is a water soluble naturally, and this is also heat labile. Now it contains a pyrimidine ring attached to the thiazole ring via methylene bridge. So big names, it looks like this. Rings and all are there. Now what is the source of thiamine? It is present in the aleurone layer of the cereals. So it is important what sort of cereals. It is present in the aleurone layer of the cereals. So the cereals, when they are processed, if the aleurone layer is lost, the cereal will be deficient in thiamine. So it is present, though it is supposed to be present in rice, wheat, pulses, oil, seeds, nuts, yeast, everywhere it is present thiamine. But if the rice is highly polished rice, it will lose its aleurone layer, and then it, a polished rice will not be containing adequate levels of thiamine. Nor so which rice is better? The unpolished rice are considered better because the aleurone layer is still intact. Now there is something called as parboiling of rice. Parboiling of rice is also a method by which they try to conserve that vitamins in the rice and bring it out. So thiamine is present in rice, wheat, pulses. Now animal sources include pork, liver, kidney, milk, etc. present in containing thiamine. The RDA is around 1 to 1.5 milligrams per day. Most of the water soluble vitamins are in the range of 1 to 2 milligrams per day, the RDA, except for vitamin C, which is 60 milligrams per day. Rest all of them are in the range of 1.2, 1.5, less than 2 milligrams usually is the RDA. Now, what is the active form? How is it synthesized? Remember, most of these water-soluble vitamins act as coenzyme compared to the fat solubles. Fat solubles act at the level of, if you look at vitamin A, it is involved in gene regulation, gene expression regulation. Vitamin D is also involved in gene expression regulation. Vitamin K does have a bit of a role in blood clotting, gamma carboxylation. Vitamin E is again a different way. So water soluble ones, vitamin E is an antioxidant, so it is not a coenzyme form. So again, all these water soluble ones are the ones which are involved as coenzymes. Many of them are involved in oxidation reduction reactions. Okay, most of the vitamin coenzymes are involved in oxidoreductases, contain a derivative of any vitamin. So let us look at the synthesis of thiamine. Thiamine is converted to thiamine pyrophosphate, and for this the enzyme is thiamine pyrophosphate transferase, which is utilizes ATP. So in this, what happens? Two more phosphate groups are attached to thiamine. So thiamine pyrophosphate is the active form of TPP, also known as abbreviations. Yes, PLP, TPP, all the FHA, THFA, tetrahydrofolic acid, PLP, pyridoxal phosphate, TPP is thiamine pyrophosphate. Abbreviation should be known. TPP is what is used. Biochemical functions, it is a vitamin of carbohydrate metabolism. Pyridoxal phosphate is a vitamin of amino acid metabolism. Thiamine is a vitamin of carbohydrate metabolism. So it mainly undergoes what is called, helps in catalyzing what is called as oxidative decarboxylation. Oxidative means thiamine pyrophosphate, the active form is what is involved. Thiamine pyrophosphate oxidative decarboxylation substance is usually converted to its CoA derivative. Decarboxylation is going to take place. Decarboxylation, CoA is going to be added, and plus at the same time NAD is converted to NADH plus H plus, and plus this oxidative carboxylation also requires the requirement of lipoic acid, FAD, five different coenzyme A, all these five different vitamins are involved. These are all present. The same type of reaction is happening in different carbohydrate metabolism. This is the main thing, both in carbohydrate and in amino acid metabolism, but mainly in carbohydrate, PDH complex and alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase complex. So it is a coenzyme of energy generating reactions. Four enzymes: PDH, alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, transketolase. These three are involved in carbohydrate metabolism. Another enzyme is branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase. So this is also similar to that. Amino acid is converted to branch chain alpha keto acid is converted to its respective formation CoA form, and this is in amino acid metabolism. So let us look at the different ways. So glucose pyruvate, we have already told to you. So PDH requires TPP. Acetyl CoA to alpha ketoglutarate in the TCA cycle requires alpha TPP. So in glucose metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism, thiamine pyrophosphate is required. Glucose, because HMP shunt, transketolase. So again, it requires TPP. So thiamine pyrophosphate. HMP shunt is involved in NADPH and ribose metabolism. Acetyl-CoA is required for acetylcholine. If this is blocked, what will happen? Pyruvate is going to get goes to some other pathway. So energy production, acetyl-CoA formation, reducing equivalence are formed. It is involved in NADPH, so lipid synthesis, and nucleic acid synthesis because of ribose 5-phosphate. So these are the overall functions of thiamine pyrophosphate. All these are the different functions of thiamine pyrophosphate. So let us look at what will be the effect if thiamine is not there. What will happen? And we call that condition beriberi. Beriberi means, actually the word has come from some African language, which means I cannot. Why do they say I cannot? They ask them to do some work, they say I cannot do it. Anything else, I cannot do it. I cannot is beriberi. Why do they say that? They are always having a lot of problem to get up only, so they feel that they won't do any work. They are so much tired because of vitamin B1 deficiency. Beriberi, there are four different types: wet beriberi, dry beriberi, infantile beriberi, and what is called as cerebral beriberi or Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. I won't deal much about all this. I'll just talk about wet beriberi and dry beriberi. What is wet beriberi? Usually it is seen in people who are having adequate carbohydrate diet, but which is deficient in thiamine. Now what is happening, main thing is, pyruvate has come from carbohydrate. Okay, pyruvate is getting converted to acetyl-CoA. And for this, it requires thiamine. So suppose thiamine is deficient here, what will happen? Carbohydrate is adequate, this pyruvate will accumulate because it cannot go further. When it cannot go further, pyruvate will get converted to lactic acid. When lactic acid accumulates, what will happen? It is hygroscopic, it will then lead to water retention and all the cardiovascular symptoms. So a person who is having adequate diet but deficient only in thiamine, this will happen. But at the same time, there is one more case that may be possible. Same vitamin, different features. Why it is possible? Suppose somebody is not taking both the carbohydrate and thiamine. Carbohydrate is also not there, thiamine is also not there. So that time, whatever little pyruvate is also not going to be there. So acetyl-CoA is also not going to be there, but pyruvate accumulation is not going to take place because no carbohydrate at all. So at that time, all the deficiency manifestation will be because of lack of acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is required for acetylcholine formation. So in this case, acetylcholine, nerve impulse. So all the different neurological symptoms. So the same vitamin deficiency, depending upon other conditions, can cause so diverse effects. One will be a wet beriberi full of cardiovascular symptoms. The other will be dry beriberi full of neurological symptoms. It all depends on whether pyruvate is there in the diet or not. Pyruvate won't be there. I mean, glucose is there in the diet or not. So depending on that, we can have diverse symptoms. So wet beriberi is seen in adequate carbohydrate diet but deficient cardiovascular symptoms. That's why wet means something related to edema. Okay, so there will be edema of legs, face and trunk, palpitation, breathlessness, bounding pulse, finally leading to cardiomegaly and can lead to death. The other general symptoms will be there, like weakness, again acetylcholine, anorexia, nausea, depression. All these are definitely going to be there, but the most important thing is the edema that is present because of the accumulation of lactic acid. So what is the biochemical basis? Glucose is plenty. Pyruvate is formed. Pyruvate cannot be converted. Pyruvate accumulates. Pyruvate converted to lactate. Lactic acidosis. Lactate accumulates, leading to edema. Edema overburdens the heart, finally leading to cardiomegaly and heart failure. Remember, no generation of ATP, so the person will be also having weakness. Dry beriberi deficient both in carbohydrates and thiamine. So all neurological symptoms. Peripheral neuritis will complain of pins and needles around the peripheries. Muscles become progressively weak, deep muscle pain, won't feel like getting up at all. But there is no edema in this. General symptoms like weakness, fatigue, poor appetite, etc. So what is the biochemical basis? Lack of both carbohydrate and thiamine. ATP production decreases, leading to weakness. Formation of acetyl-CoA is decreased, so acetylcholine is decreased. So nerve impulsion through impulse transmission through synapses is affected, leading to neuritis, muscular weakness and deep muscle pains. So infantile beriberi, when infant is born to a thiamine deficient mother. The mother is a thiamine deficient. So what will happen? It will lead to restlessness, sleeplessness. And if breast milk is deficient in thiamine, it can lead to tachycardia, anorexia, vomiting, convulsions, aphonia and encephalopathy. Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, usually it is called a cerebral beriberi also, but it is mainly associated with alcoholism. Now what is happening in alcoholism? NADH, remember the alcohol metabolism. Alcohol is converted to acetaldehyde, acetaldehyde to acetate. And in that time, what is happening? The amount of NADH produced is more. And NADH converts pyruvate to lactate. So again, acetyl-CoA is not there. This thiamine is also at the same time. The chronic alcoholics taking only alcohol. There is no diet. Diet is deficient in thiamine. All these will lead to all the different symptoms of Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. Is mainly seen in chronic alcoholics. Alcoholics eat poorly, plus alcohol also inhibits vitamin B1 absorption. Whatever little is taken, those also thiamine is not going to be absorbed. So the clinical features are what are classic clinical features is called as nystagmus. Nystagmus is rhythmic to and fro movements of the eyeball. The eyeball is going to move like this by itself. Rhythmic to and fro movements of the eyeball is called as nystagmus. This is a classic feature of thiamine deficiency leading to Wernicke-Korsakoff psychosis. They say there are differences in that also, Wernicke syndrome and Korsakoff psychosis, but I'm combined both of them. Many books do that. As you go higher, you can know the difference between Wernicke's encephalopathy and Korsakoff's psychosis. So clinical features are mainly nystagmus, ataxia, ophthalmoplegia, and Korsakoff psychosis. One classic thing is confabulation. That is, they are going to lie about what has happened and they feel it is the truth. So they are going to lie, where have we gone? I have been here, I had been, something happened, this, that, so many false stories. Confabulation is the classic feature of Korsakoff's psychosis. Thiamine antagonist, one word. Thiaminase is present in raw fish and seafoods. Pyrethiamine is present in ferns. And thiamine levels are basically detected by RBC transketolase levels. RBC in the erythrocyte, transketolase level. So with this, we come to the end of thiamine, vitamin B1 and vitamin C. In the next session, I'll talk about the other vitamins. Thank you.